In today's video, we're testing out a comment asking if it's possible to boil water in a wooden bowl. All right, we've got a couple of wooden bowls and we're gonna try boiling water in them. The problem, of course, is that wood does not conduct heat nearly as well as, say, a metal bowl, which is what you'd normally want to do this in, or maybe glass if it were in the microwave. Wood's pretty uncommon for boiling. Doesn't conduct heat well.
It's a little bit more insulated, so it's going to be a little bit harder for that heat to transfer through.
And maybe it's so insulated even that the outside will actually, like, catch on fire or something like that before it gets the water boiling. So the question is if we can get the water to boil without the bowl burning up and disintegrating.
Here's the basic idea. We are going to try and boil water in our wooden bowl, first on the electric burner, then on the propane stove, and last in our forge.
First, let's try it on an electric burner. All right, we did not get water to boil on our electric stove. Maybe it just doesn't get hot enough. It burned quite a bit on the bottom. It didn't ever really light on fire. And we got water that started heating up, like there's steam. There was even, I think, some little bubbles down at the bottom. It's very hot water, but it definitely wasn't boiling water. So I think we need to step our game up.
Now we're gonna try the propane stove.
As a comparison with this propane stove, I wanna try a metal bowl and we're gonna time it. We're gonna see how long it takes for it to boil in a metal bowl and then compare that to the wooden bowl after, if it will even boil in the metal bowl.
Is it bad that I'm hoping this doesn't work just so that we can light the foundry? I am very cold.
It's a metal bowl. It's gonna go pretty quick, I suspect. That is a decent amount of water, and so it does have a certain amount of energy it has to take before it gets to a boiling point, but like it's already making little bubbles right at the very contact, like at the bottom of the bowl. I think it's gonna go pretty quick.
We shouldn't have a problem here.
Oh.
Wow.
You say that's boiling?
That's boiling.
That looks like boiling water. 2 minutes and 48 seconds it took for that to hit full boil. That's pretty quick.
Yeah.
All right. Now we see if we can get the water to boil or if we just have a bowl on fire or maybe like the top will be on fire.
Normally when you put anything that contains water in the fire, the edges might burn, but yeah. The water, it waits until it evaporates until the material itself starts to burn. So we could get a fire up here, we could get scorching on the bottom, but I don't think the sides are gonna burn. That's just not gonna happen.
We'll find out.
There we go, it's a lot of fire. And it is going up the sides of the bowl quite a bit. In fact, some of those yellow flames, I believe, are the bowl catching on fire already.
Yeah.
So, we've got a bowl on fire.
Yeah.
But that doesn't mean this isn't going to work. With paper cups, I have seen it. You put a paper cup in, you fill water, maybe with an egg in there, and it burns the edge. Like, it burns down to the level of the water because what keeps it from burning is all of the heat going into the water instead of staying on the cup itself. But on this top rim around it, which definitely looks like it's lighting on fire.
You know, that's the lacquer. I think we're burning the lacquer coating right now.
It does kind of smell like that.
Yeah, this doesn't smell like a wood burn. This is definitely a chemical like lacquer burn here.
But it's also down at the bottom. Yeah, the wood is like cracking and stuff down at the bottom. So down there.
Oh, actually, that's true. This is a glued bowl. This isn't like carved out one piece. So if we crack apart whatever's holding the bowl together.
It could just.
We might want to move away.
All right. Well, can I just point out that this looks like the Goblet of Fire or something from Harry Potter because it's like a bowl that's on fire.
Does anybody have a scrap of paper? I need to write my name immediately. The flame is definitely going out from where it was burning the bowl, but look.
There are bubbles forming on the sides of the bowl. Now, I don't know if that's gases expanding through the sides of the bowl or if that's actually from the heat of the water.
No, what I'm loving here is you can actually see this charred edge and then down below, you're still seeing that beautiful wood finish.
Not only the charred edge, but as you said, it is a bowl that's been glued together and it's splitting apart. So we've just got these very even sections going and it's looking like a flower with petals.
I wonder what would happen if you just set one of these bowls on fire. Would it just like bloom out?
We definitely are not at a boil yet.
No, I can still put my hand in that. So this is gonna take longer. Well, it's been 31 minutes and counting.
Yeah, we are over half an hour. Remember, it took 2 minutes and 48 seconds to boil in our metal bowl. And over half an hour, a lot of the bowl is burned. The bottom of the bowl is just like made of embers.
The inside of the bowl, the lacquer is actually starting to bubble up, meaning the whole thing is starting to separate.
Yeah, it's hot water.
I wasn't wearing gloves. Yes, these aren't very insulating, but there's still some protection. If I didn't have gloves on, I wouldn't be putting my hand in that. But the fact that I can still put my hand in there for several seconds, I don't think we're that close to boiling yet.
I think we need to scale it up one more time. We've got our foundry. We're gonna try a couple things. First, we're gonna use a lot more heat because that thing puts out a lot of heat. And second, we're gonna try filling the bowl all the way. And it might be counterintuitive thinking like, oh, more water, it's gonna be harder to boil. But it should insulate the sides so less of the bowl burns up. We're gonna try it.
This is much nicer. I like this much more. This is better.
Plenty of roaring heat coming off that. Now I expect it's still gonna burn the outside of the bowl.
Oh yeah.
That's
but the nice
question.
Part about this is that we're gonna get an ambient heat all the way around it just from the heat coming off of the top. I think that's really gonna help.
Oh, there we go. There's our lacquer.
Yes, there it
and,
goes.
And I'm sure some of the wood lighting.
Already on the inside, we've got that ring of bubbles forming, so. But you can also see.
And a black ring around the top.
I think our lacquer on the inside has already begun to melt.
All right, we don't have the same kind of boil that we did with the metal pot, but we do have water boiling. Weirdly, it seems to only be boiling on one side where more of the heat is directly going. It was centered originally, but for some reason has started to settle over to one edge, and the other side just isn't boiling as much, so it's very much where it's right in contact with the fire.
We're getting this frothy boil, and it's less than half the amount of time that we spent on the one with the propane burner.
So yeah. Yes, it's boiling.
We did it. We made it happen.
So a rolling boil, that's what happens when the average temperature is hot enough that it will evaporate. And I don't think we actually have that. We have something you could cook in. I think it is boiling and you could cook with it, but I don't think we have the same type of rolling boil where the average temperature is hot enough to evaporate because it's only boiling on the side with more heat directly blowing onto it.
But it's less than half the amount of time that it took to even get this to start bubbling and there was more water, so I'm calling that a success. All right, this is probably gonna fall apart, but let's see if we can pick it up.
Oh, it's soft. Still bubbling. That to me means we really did it because the water is still boiling. Our bowl actually is basically on fire down here, so it's still putting heat into the water.
So Nate was hungry, and it's lunchtime, and we have some boiling water. Chemical water. Well, while Nate makes lunch, I'm gonna try and pick up the bowl that we had on the propane burner. I'm curious to see if it's gonna hold together. So right now you can see there's ash in there. The varnish has bubbled. I'm gonna pour this out real quick. I think mostly at this point it's just steaming because it is freezing in here, but you can see the varnish that's just bubbled up off of this bowl. Now let's look at the bottom. Nate, look at this.
I got this one now too.
Oh, wow. So you can see already the heat difference here.
That's a pretty cool looking bowl, honestly. It's also much lighter weight.
Right?
Lost a lot of mass. We set out to see if you can boil water in a wooden bowl, and yes, it turns out you can. It's just horrendously impractical.
In a survival situation, if you didn't have a metal bowl, you would probably have to stick a wooden bowl right in the center of a fire, so.
And I don't think you'd be able to do it too many times before your bowl got used up. There are traditional methods of boiling water in flammable containers by like taking a hot rock out of the fire and putting that into the water inside the container. But we were trying to actually just boil it the way you boil stuff in a bowl or a pot. Guys, that's it for today, but you know we've always got more for you. To see that box up at the top will take you directly to our last video. You should go check that out. The other box shows you what YouTube thinks you should be watching next. Give that a click as well. If you hit this bomb in the middle, you'll be subscribed to our channel. That way you'll never miss out on a video. Don't forget to ring that bell, and we will see you in the next one. Talk to you then.